Okay, so you're no longer in Northern California now. You're living in
Colorado.
Colorado. And you, it's funny because we got really, really tight right before you left. And something that you're dealing with right now, and something that I must say I'm incredibly proud of you for dealing with head on. We butt heads on it a couple of times, and
Yeah.
I'm glad that our friendship stayed intact with me being as like aggressive as I was about it.
I
So,
appreciate that.
and this is something that your viewers don't know about,
No, they
but it's
don't.
something that you just celebrated a milestone on.
Correct.
So let's talk about that.
My YouTubers, the reason why I started YouTubing was to blog about my gastric bypass. And, did that and it helped a lot of people. So my addiction to food was, kind of what I was into back then. And then I decided to have this gastric bypass, and I had it, and I lost all this weight. And then I went from one addiction to another addiction, and it was a cross addiction, and it happened very quickly, and it was alcoholism. And so, my viewers don't know that I'm a recovering alcoholic, and it's been 3 years of hell since my gastric bypass.
So what was, as my phone rings in the background, what was your bottom? What made you decide, because you reached out for help. No one had to do an intervention for you. What made you decide, you know what, this is the bottom, enough's enough? Go ahead.
I think after 6 relapses of trying to quit on my own, trying to stop drinking on my own, finally my bottom was laying in my bedroom with a room full of wine bottles and not being able to function in the morning without drinking, having the shakes and the dry heaves in the morning, needing a drink at 8 a.m. and needing a drink probably every couple of hours, drinking at work, losing everything, and laying on the floor of my bedroom in complete despair. And I didn't know where to turn. I didn't know what to do. I knew that I was very sick. So I called my parents, who live out here in Colorado, and I said, I need help. I need help. I had gone through 6 relapses without them knowing. I had gone through all this stuff without them knowing. So I called them up, and my stepmom and my sister got in the car and drove to California, packed me up, and drove me back home. And I detoxed here and got involved in AA right away, got a sponsor, started the program, started working the steps, started volunteering. And 2 days ago, I celebrated 2 months of sobriety.
Good for
So,
you, Kelly. Good for you. And I must say, when we got close, I knew something was going on. I knew something was going on. And I remember asking you, what are you drinking? You said apple juice. And I just remember the last night I talked to you is I had to like hang up. 'Cause I was just like, I'm not gonna be an enabler, I'm not gonna do this. And I remember just saying to myself, she's gonna be okay. She'll be okay. And I remember thinking to myself, our friendship is strong enough that eventually she'll reach out again. And you did. You did. And you look a whole, your smile is so much brighter. Your face, everything, there's this glow around you. You're doing an incredible thing, Kelly, and I am so proud of you. I
Thank
am
you.
so proud of you. Your smile is just so much different.
Thank you. I'm very blessed. I'm very blessed. And I finally, you know, my family here, they just want me to get sober. And that is my main focus right now, mm-hmm. is sobriety. Okay. And so, and I thank you for your patience through this, because I know that that was really difficult to speak to me when I was so bad. Mm-hmm. And so thank you for accepting me for who I am and all my faults, and still hanging in there with me, I guess.
One thing that I remember growing up with my parents, and my parents always drilling into me, is that if you're somebody's friend, you're their friend, period. Through rough, tough, anything, you're their friend. You stand with them. And I wasn't about to turn my back on you. I mean, you've seen me go through some tough things, and you've seen the comments on my channel and the attacks on my channel, and you are one of few people who were just like, you know what, I'm your friend. And it's rare that you meet people like that. We have a lot of people around us, but how many are your real friends?
It's really true. And who would have thought that I would have found you through this medium? You know, it's a trip. I mean, it's a true blessing, though.
It is a true blessing. And it's, you hear so many bad things about YouTube, and you hear so many bad things about the internet. And it's just like, some of the friendships that I've made through the internet, including yours, are just like testimonies and evident that the internet is not all bad.
No, absolutely not.
And we would probably never be friends.
Well, no, because you live in LA and I lived in Northern California, and I rarely came to LA. I mean, once in a while, but we would have never crossed paths. Or maybe we would have, you know, fate has a way of working itself out, but, yeah. So.
Okay. Great. Well, we got 3 minutes left.
3 minutes left.
Kelly, I want to thank you for doing this.
Thank you for letting me. And, you know, this has been great. And it's going to be great to kind of come out mm-hmm. to my viewers on what my life really is right now. So thank you for letting me share that.
So if there was a message you wanted to leave with anybody who might be struggling with sexual abuse, alcoholism, sexuality, or just dealing with life's ups and downs, what would that message be?
Always put your trust in God, and He will work it out for you. Let His will be done.
Okay.
Trust in the Lord. That's what I say.
No matter what.
No matter what. No matter how bad it gets, ask and you shall receive.
That's right, baby. Real quick, let's talk about some of your funny videos. You just did a video about the poopy wiper.
That's my channel. I make stupid videos about crap like that, or just whatever. Yeah.
And it ain't funny. It ain't easy being cheesy.
Yeah. Oreo. Cookie.
Yeah. What was the milk thing all about?
You know, got milk.
Yes.
So,
you've had some pretty interesting responses to your got milk.
Oh my gosh. Yeah, some pretty, I don't want to go there. Yeah.
Kelly, thank you so much for doing this interview. You are an amazing woman, and I'm glad you shared your story with us.
Oh, thank you so much. And you're such an inspiration. You really, really are to so many people. You don't know how many people you touch. You really have no idea.
Thank you. Continue
your hard work and continue your outreach and continue being yourself. It's been a blessing all these years, so thank you.
Thank you. I know, all these years. Is that funny or what? Yeah, all these years. Thank you so much. Give us your YouTube channel.
It's Kelly Kell 34. K-E-L-L-Y-K-E-L 34.
So you guys, go subscribe. Her videos are really, really funny, and she's an amazing woman. Kelly, thanks for sharing today.
Thank you, sweetie.
All right. Bye-bye.
Love you.